Welcome to the Grouch Shop and part two in my series, the Kodi Compendium. So like I was saying in part one, you can run Kodi on just about any platform you can think of. I used to run it on an old Dell computer from like 2004, but eventually it kind of started conking out on me and I decided to upgrade to something a little smaller and sleeker and also cost effective. So I got a Raspberry Pi 3B Plus here, and this kit's from Vilros, and as you can see, it's already pretty cheap, but a coupon and a few reward points make it even cheaper. So pretty much this kit includes everything you need except the HDMI cable, which I already had several of those. There's a lot of different kits available depending on what you have and what you need. The kit comes with a polycarbonate case, so you need to put on these heat sinks. It does include the thermal compound, but I'm not totally sure why, because the heat sinks have thermal sticky pads. You don't want to use thermal compound underneath the sticky pad. Maybe they included the thermal compound in case you're going to use an aluminum case. Either way, it's nice to have it. Hey, you can see the Raspberry Pi 3 is really nothing more than a credit card size computer. One thing about the Pi though, there's no off switch. So nice thing about this kit, it comes with a power adapter that has an on-off switch. Of course, there's other ways to control the power. We'll get into that more later in the series. It's a good idea to use some kind of case to cover up your Pi to protect against dust, accidental shorts, other types of mayhem. This one comes with two different tops. One with the big opening is for GPIO pins, which we won't be using for Kodi. Incidentally, GPIO stands for General Purpose Input Output. Allows you to control different things with your Pi if you want. I mentioned briefly about other types of cases. This is a pretty cool one made by FLIRC. And it's a Kodi branded aluminum case. I'll be using some different cases later on and I'll get into comparing the different cases. So on a 3B Plus Pi like this, your hard drive, quote unquote, or mass storage device is a micro SD card. I got a 32 gigabyte, but an 8 or a 16 would do fine. Now for my HID or human interface device for this project, I decided to go ahead with an AceMax wireless keypad. Works in the 2.4 gigahertz range. Not Bluetooth, not Wi-Fi, either of those as far as I can tell, but did not appear to cause any interference problems either. It comes with a little dongle that you plug into your device, the Raspberry Pi 3 in this case. And it comes with a removable, rechargeable battery, which looks oddly like the old Nokia phone batteries. It's kind of weird. But anyway, it's nice to have the full keypad sometimes when you're interfacing with Kodi, especially for setup. It also has backlighting and different colors you can choose for backlighting, which is really nice. I mean, all this for 20 bucks, you know, it's kind of hard to beat. I do have a way to interface with Kodi with the standard universal remote. I got into that some in my JP1 series. I'll get into it more here in the Kodi series in one of the later episodes. So now the thermal management in this current generation of Pi is much better than the previous gens. And to some extent, you really don't need the heat sinks necessarily, but they will reduce the amount of CPU throttling. So I recommend using them both. Just peel the backing off. Don't use any of the thermal compound. Place the large one directly on the big silver chip that says Broadcom. That's your SoC or SoC or system on a chip. Includes the main processor, the ARM processor. And once you place it on, just apply a gentle pressure for about a minute or so. And then the smaller heat sink is going to go on the little black chip to the right there. That's the network USB interface chip. And same process for that chip. Okay, with the heat sinks in place, you're ready to put the board into the case. Bottom part first, and it just takes a little bit of finagling. You want to be kind of gentle. You don't want to put too much pressure on any one location. Just keep sort of rocking it back and forth, and it'll go in there, and you'll hear it snap once it's in there. And then the top part of the case is even easier. It's just got some little flanges. You want to make sure those flanges go in properly and just snap it right down. Now in part three, I'll get into the OS selection and installation part of the project. But for now, just to show you how it's going to look with everything hooked up, the power comes through the micro USB cable. You have the HDMI cable there. And then we'll have the dongle from the wireless keyboard. And then there'll be an option to have a network cable, or if you don't use a wired connection, you can use wireless. I'll show you what the network cable looks like in a second. And then here's the FLIRC I was talking about earlier. It's basically an IR receiver. So if you use a IR universal remote, you can use that to control Kodi in addition to using the wireless keyboard. This particular FLIRC dongle is one of the earlier gens. There's been a few revisions to it. I'll put some links below to the current gen release of that, along with the links to all the other stuff below. So now, yeah, adding in the Ethernet cable, it starts to look kind of comical with all the cables coming off this tiny box. But I don't like the position where they put the Ethernet port. As you can see, if you want your IR dongles or your Bluetooth dongles sticking out front, your Ethernet's kind of in the way. I looked around. There's some kind of angled Ethernet adapters you could use if you wanted, like this. And yeah, you could even hook a couple of them together, maybe make a U-shape out of it. Another option, of course, is just to use the wireless. This version of the Pi has a pretty good Wi-Fi, including AC, 2.4 gigahertz and 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi. So this concludes episode 2 in our Kodi hardware platform selection and build prep. You guys be sure to stay tuned for episode 3 and beyond. We'll get into the OS selection and Kodi install and config and all that good stuff. But for now, that's how it's done. Thanks for watching.